The novel is about a woman who has just had her first child and moved away from New York City out into the country, and she encounters a college-age babysitter, and the two of them develop sort of an unlikely bond. And it's about a lot of things. It's about motherhood and friendship, but it's also really about social class and sort of what's happened to the American dream, if it ever existed in the first place, and sort of looks at the idea of privilege in a lot of different forms. It's very much a conversation between my younger self and the self I am at this point in life. So when I was in college, I was a nanny and then a babysitter, and I worked for a family with a young baby, and there was this mother who I did, you know, develop a friendship with, nowhere near as dramatic as the one in the book, of course, but that was certainly at the root of it. And I, many years later, after I worked with this family, I ran into this woman. I had then published a couple of books and was sort of in a different place, and she had very much put me on the path to going to New York and being a writer and all of these things. We had this run-in 10 years later, and I just sort of, you know, thought it would be an interesting opening for a novel, but I didn't know exactly what I would say about that older character yet, because I wasn't yet there. And then when I was pregnant with my first child, I started to sort of write these sections from the point of view of the babysitter character, not really knowing what the new mother would say yet, but knowing that I would soon know what to say. And it was very much sort of a conversation between not just myself and my younger self, but a woman in her 30s versus a woman in her early 20s, and what these sort of different stages look like, and what you think you're going to become versus what you actually do, and, you know, sort of being a mentor or being the older figure in the life of a younger woman, and what that looks like as well. So I think, like most writers, I started out as a reader, and it was a love of reading other people's work that made me want to try my hand at writing. And even as a really young child, I was always writing short stories and poems and plays. And, you know, I think they were always in some way kind of about my family or the drama that was happening in our neighborhood. They were kind of these miniature versions of what I'm still writing now, 30 some years later. But they were all kind of trying to make sense of the world around me, which is still why I write today. When I was about 8 or 9 years old, we had a professional writer who wrote children's books come to our school and speak, and it was the first time I had ever really realized that writing could be a job. And from then on, I very much dreamed of being a writer. Very honored to be published in France, and I love how deeply readers here engage with books and stories. And it really is different than any place else, I think. So it's quite an honor. The reviewers here really understand more that there's sort of the story, and then there's the sort of bigger issues in the story. And I think a lot of times, especially with women writers in the States, it becomes, oh, this is a women's fiction book, or this is about two women and their friendship. But I find that in France, the reviewers go much deeper than that, and, you know, realize that it's also a book about class. It's also a book about race and privilege, and, you know, how America has changed and not changed. So I quite like that.